What's the best laundry stain remover? I'm Zach, a fourth generation dry cleaner who loves talking about laundry and testing cleaning products. I tested 10 different laundry stain removing products using the AISE standard procedure for laundry testing, which I'll explain after results, as that's probably why you're here. So without further ado, your product analysis. There are three at the very top: Miss Mounts Messy Eater, Dad Mode, and straight up liquid laundry detergent, specifically a really good one. The worst two, which should be avoided at all costs, are the pink stuff and grandma's secret spot remover. But let's dive a little bit deeper into the data, as most of these products have some really interesting strengths, which are worth noting. Miss Mounts had the best performance by a very small margin. It's also portable and did a great job against food and oil stains thanks to its very high citric acid component, which also makes for a neat party trick when applied to red wine or berries, as shown by the many TikToks and reels out there. This product is also made by the same people who make this Chateau Spill red wine remover. Dad Mode, a newcomer to the market, was extremely solid in all categories. This level of well-roundedness proved to be difficult, as most products excelled in some categories but were weak in others. And believe it or not, straight up high-performing liquid laundry detergent like Persil or Tide Stain Release hung with the best of them, making it quite a useful laundry hack. Just rub a little bit in. And maybe showed us that having standalone products is a bit redundant. OxiClean Max Force just missed the podium and had very solid results overall, and it performed really well, the best, against makeup stains. Highly recommend for makeup stains. And while we're talking makeup, Shout also excelled here, but was really weak elsewhere. Disappointing for me, because I used to be a big Shout guy, until today. Zout did the best against special stains like oil-based paint, Sharpie, and pen ink, and very average everywhere else. Amodex, solid but a bit annoying to use. It was top three in the special category, that's the inks. And even though it says it removes ink, it won't be what I'm grabbing for ink stains. There's just better products out there. Clorox was very average, but quite messy. A spray bottle version would be really nice. And now it's time to discuss the bottom two. Grandma's was second to last. I can't find an ingredient list anywhere, so I'm guessing it's missing some really important cleaning components. The pink stuff, unlike the branding it mentions, is a miraculously bad stain remover, and it was in the bottom three in every category. When I looked it up, it's basically just soap, surfactants, citric acid, hydrogen peroxide. Not including enzymes in a stain removal product is like not including flour in your bread recipe. What's the point? Now that you have these results, I'm going to briefly explain my testing process. This process, which is very, very similar to how I test laundry detergents, has a few tweaks. To start backing up a little bit, this isn't my procedure. It's the industry standard. It's the AISE procedure, and it's used by all the big testing companies. So I used white cotton swatches and then stained it with 20 hard to remove stains. When I test detergents, I only use 18. The two extras were a blue ink and Sharpie. Another difference between this and the detergent testing was that I let these swatches dry for 3 days before treating, which in theory should make these stains harder to remove. I only let the detergent swatches hang out for about a day. I ran these tests twice in two machines. The first test was only letting the treatment sit for about 5 minutes on the stain. The second, about an hour pre-treatment, which should be the minimum for best results, by the way. I did these tests twice, one in a not so great top loading machine, the other in a very nice Miele front loading machine. The more data, the better, in my opinion, to ensure those outliers average and level out. With 10 products and 20 per swatch and 4 cycles, that gives me 800 data points, so I'm pretty confident in these results. So after washing, testing, I air dried them and measured them again with my spectrometer and started mining the data, which was honestly kind of a blast. I should get a new hobby. Let me mention something else that's important that differed from how I currently test detergents, but something that I will start integrating in my detergent reviews. I took these 20 stains and put them into 5 groups when I started looking at the data. Normally, the 5 stain categories are oily, enzymatic, oxidizable, particulate, and special. My categories were almost the same for this test, but I swapped out oxidizable for an array of makeup stains. That's because oxidizable stains, also known as bleachable stains, are not difficult to remove. Oxidable stains are bright, tannin-based stains like tea, red wine, coffee, curries, turmerics that easily come out with bleach. Essentially, if a stain comes out too easily, that makes the data useless for me. Other than that, I do my best to control as many variables as possible. The good news is that this test is easily recreatable, so let me know which products I missed and that you'd like to see tested, and I'll get to work. That's all I got for you today. I hope this helps you make better purchasing decisions in the future.